preview.
So, hi. I thought I was going to be the one energizing the audience, but Partth has done it already. I'm going to share my journey in this brief period that I'll be talking. And what led me to think this way and what was the whole story kind of moved me in several ways, and which is all that I'll be talking about. And so first of all, how I was born, of course, because of my parents. And like everyone, I was born by addition. Traits of two people came into me. And talking a bit about how I grew up, I love adventure sports. And on my 20th birthday, I did a scuba diving course in Bali. I went alone. My parents asked me, do you want a new phone or do you want to do something new? So I said, okay, new. And I just went off. It was my first solo trip and it was directly abroad. So that was a good experience. I started traveling to Ladakh. I did a lot of treks and I kept challenging myself in extreme climates and extreme conditions. You'll know why I did that later, but I kept doing that. And so now this quote, actually, it's better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. Isn't that right? So I feel each of us, like I think even Mansi shared this, do what you love and love what you do. It's very important that each one of us, no matter what you are doing, it's very important to love what you are doing. And now why the topic, like why was the title A Redless Destiny? It is because of this. I suffer from something called as Thalassemia Major. I don't call it a suffering. It's a part of me. It's probably my profession now because I'm so used to it. But I've taken it on me and it took some time, but now it's a part of me. It is called as Thalassemia Major, and it happened to me because my parents were thalassemia minors. And when two thalassemia minors have a child, turns out the kid has Thalassemia Major. It's a genetic disorder. It's not something that spreads through touch or, you know, through physical means. It comes through genetics. Amitabh Bachchan is a thalassemia minor. Just imagine if Jaya Bachchan also had it, there would have been a possibility. But it is just genetics. And my parents knew about this much later after I was born. And once I was, there is no cure. Your body cannot make blood. You need blood transfusions every 15 days. That's lifelong. In fact, earlier when I was born, I was smaller. And I needed less blood. As you tend to grow older, you need more blood. So the frequency of your blood transfusions increases as you grow. So it's a progressive disorder. So muddy water is best cleared by leaving it alone. You need to understand that some things, when they happen to you, you need to look at it from the other side as well. It's very important that it happened to me. Thalassemia is now a part of me. But I can't just be focusing that as a disability or as a suffering. I need to look beyond that. And that was when I started, you know, spending a lot of time traveling. And, you know, I was also really good with my field. I did my master's in biotechnology from St. Xavier's College, Bombay. And I really enjoyed that. And I love animals, which is this picture. And until one fine day when I was 19, my parents were not home, and I'm the only child, and I lost my dog suddenly. She was 3 years old, and she just collapsed, and that was the first time I actually witnessed death. So until then, I had never known about this, like how it really happens, how a breathing body suddenly goes out of life. It was horrific, and I couldn't go to college for like 7-8 days just thinking about how she passed away. But those 7 days kind of made me realize that life is so uncertain. She was a 3-year-old dog. She passed away due to a cardiac outbreak. But it's so uncertain. Like anything can happen to you at any moment. So it's very important that you live each moment to the best of your capability. Which is why I started the Wishing Factory. And I'm the founder. And we have about a team of 65 people all over India. And 33% of our employees are only thalassemia major patients. And thank you. So what we really do is, we're based out of 7-8 cities now. And what we really do is we fulfill wishes of children. We empower their education. We give them scholarships. We help them with healthcare. So as a patient, you need a lot of medicines. You need every 15 days, if you need blood, you also need a blood filter. Now, one blood filter is 1,000 rupees, 1,100. So imagine I need 2 units of blood, so 2 packed cells of blood. So I need 2 blood filters every 15 days. So imagine the costing that is also involved. So each patient cannot really afford these. And there are so many patients who we deal with who cannot really afford the cost of their medicines, their healthcare, which is why we come in and we support these patients through generous donors like you. And so that's the areas that we work in, wishes, education, healthcare. We've also spread a lot of awareness in colleges, in companies. We talk about how thalassemia happens, because before you fall in love or before you get married, it's important that you know that if 2 thalassemia minors are there, you can avoid the whole situation. You can conceive through IVF, or there are other means. I'm not saying that please don't fall in love if both of you are minors. But have a child in a more thoughtful process. This was the first team meeting when we started. And this was December 2015. I was 19. It was a difficult phase, convincing companies to fund me. You know, there's something called a CSR. Some of you might be aware about. And companies used to fund through that. But as a 19-year-old individual, I wrote to 63 companies asking for funds. 2 of them replied. Out of 63 companies, 2 of them replied. 61 of them never replied to me. And those were Inox and Indian Railways. Both of them were the first 2 companies through which I received funds. And I'm really thankful to them. Because of them, I could set up 3 blood transfusion centers in India. And now they give accessible healthcare for free. This was the first article, the first media recognition I ever got. But this was just after I started. And so it was obviously a memory. And so this is something that I always keep saying, that, you know, remember, every cloud eventually runs out of rain. What you're experiencing now is just a season, not the overall climate. So each of us might be going through some tough point or some low point in your life, but that doesn't mean that's where you're going to always be. You're going to come up, and you need that power. You need that zeal to push harder. So you have to find those little moments of joy that help you push harder and keep thriving because of them. And this was the first wish. So I'm just take you through how the Wishing Factory gradually grew. And this was the first wish, a small one. Someone wanted to go to Manali, experience snowfall. Their wish, children are very specific. We got a wish from Varanasi. The kid wanted a box full of Alfonso mangoes. So they are very specific with their wishes. And we do a nice study. It's called as a background study as to why the wish, you know, kid really wants that. That child, his dad was a cobbler, a mochi. And his mom was a housemaid. They had never had Alfonso mangoes, but they had heard that it's the sweetest. So that was his wish. So that's fair. Someone wants to fly. Someone wants to sit in a helicopter. someone wanted to meet Kamal Hassan, someone wanted to meet Sonakshi Sinha, and you know, these kind of things. But what matters is the smiles that come out of it, the smiles, the happiness that comes out of it, it only makes them stronger. And so till now, it's been 3 years, and we have fulfilled 376 wishes all over India. Thank you. And as a part of our awareness initiative, what we also do is something called as a photo story exhibition. This is NCPA in Bombay, this is the National Center for Performing Arts. We have done exhibitions in Delhi, Agra, Bangalore. And these exhibitions talk about different stories, and it also promotes the message that, you know, how thalassemia really happens. And we also do a lot of art-based therapy for patients. This is because thalassemia has an inherent condition where the nose is slightly suppressed. If you can look at mine, the nose is slightly suppressed. And that's an inherent condition for the patients. And the patients often feel that they don't look good, look as good as the normal individual. So we kind of do these uplifting programs for them so that they feel more happier, so that they feel more accepting towards themselves. And this is the first blood transfusion center that I spoke about, accessible free healthcare for patients. And now the other side of thalassemia, it just doesn't stop with blood transfusions. Now, taking you through my scenario, I take blood every 15 days, so I also take a lot of iron. With the blood, iron always comes along. Plus, I also eat my roti, sabji, dal. That also has its own share of iron. So I'm building on my iron content in the body, which needs to be removed. Otherwise, your heart or your liver will eventually fail. So it's a faulty cycle. You take blood, however, you need to remove iron, which is why you need to take a lot of medicines and you need to use a pump to chelate yourself. That pump is 40,000 rupees. Patients can't really afford that pump. So what we have done is we have come up with a library system. So today, if I am a patient and there are three more, each of us can use the same pump on different days. So this was my idea and I tried to convert it. And it got a lot of traction, which is why we got the first, Gujarat's first wellness center, where we provide these pumps for free. And Telangana government, thank you. Telangana government actually saw this idea and they said, oh wow, this is brilliant. So now patients don't need to own the pump, they can rent a pump. So Telangana government wrote to us that the government wants to fund. And the government actually funded us to set up Telangana's first wellness center, which is in Warangal. And that is also a live project that now gives free pumps to patients. So what really matters is that usage of these pumps are improving the quality of life. And then, yeah, I happened to meet a lot of good people in and around while traveling in restaurants. This was Sonakshi, I met her in a coffee shop. And she happened to meet children on, I messaged her on Children's Day and she came over, she spent some good time. So thankfully I've been surrounded by good people like you who have always motivated me to work harder. And kids like these innocent looking faces that really push me harder. And the crowd in general, this is something called as crowdfunding. And we do a lot of fundraising through crowdfunding, which is like so every individual may not necessarily contribute large amounts, but someone can contribute 300 rupees, someone can contribute 100 rupees towards a child's blood filter. So it's over the last 1 year that we have realized this, and we have raised about 9 lakhs through crowdfunding, and we have been spending all of that to provide free filters to all patients in Gujarat and Maharashtra. And this is just the last bit of my thing, which I always say that, you know, good things always come back to you. And as I said, I was doing my master's in St. Xavier's College, Bombay. So I keep traveling on. Once in a month, I come back to my home, which is Baroda. And I was traveling back from Baroda to Bombay. And my trolley bag wheel, it just broke. And the platform was platform number 3. So I had to start from the parking to the platform number 3. Now, the bag was quite heavy, and a normal coolie or a normal porter takes about 200 rupees, right? Or 100 rupees, depending upon how far or what is your coach. And there's this guy who just walked up to me, seeing my broken trolley bag, and he said, "Chhod do bhaiya, main le jaunga." So I said, "No, listen, I had 50 rupees on me that time." And I said, "Ki, please don't do it. I can't really pay you." He still insisted. He took my bag, literally snatched it, and dropped me till my coach. And then he said, "Bhaiya, shayad aapne mujhe pehchana nahi." So I said, "Nahi, I don't really recognize you." So he said, "Aapne mere bacche ki wish puri kari thi." And then he showed me the pictures of his child. And you know what the wish was? The kid wanted a box of Ferrero Rochers. It was that small a wish. But it came back around to me after 2 years. So trust me, good things really come back to you. And lastly, that's a small team that we work with. And make your heart the most beautiful thing about you. Keep loving what you do and do what you love again. Thank you.